Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. My brothers, my sisters, it's important we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever we find ourselves. We've come to a time but era where gradually we become oblivious of being conscious of Allah Almighty at all times. Most of us usually would think about Allah and His fear depending on, for example, where we are, or the type of situation or circumstance we find ourselves in, or the nature of a place, or something like that. But I'd like to tell you, my brothers, my sisters, wallahi, Allah is aware of all things, and Allah sees and Allah knows. And the more you fear Allah every time, everywhere, the more Allah loves you, and the more you become a better person. The more your rank in the sight of Allah becomes bigger, and the more you become a really pious person, that whenever you would call out to Allah, Allah would instantly answer you in a big way, because it is a devoted worshipper of Allah that is calling out. You would understand the world in a better way. You would achieve much more happiness and contentment because you have a beautiful link with your deity, your maker who has made you, whom you worship, and whom you shall ultimately be returning to. I'd like to tell us as well, this life is temporary. Whatever you see here that glitters and shines, as they say, not all that glitters is gold. So something might be glittering, bling bling, but in depth it is not good. So it could glitter, but the question is it really gold? So shaitan could beautify something for you and you think that is gold, but in reality it is not gold, it is actually dirty and filthy, and the moment you go into it, that might be your destruction. So what would help you? Your link with Allah, your constant dua that Allah protects you from shaitan, the accost and his trap, and anything and everything to do with him. Be a person that would, any time if another person were to come and tell you your mistake, you would admit and you would be ready to become a better person. So in general, as a Muslim, you are supposed to be a purified person, in the sense that every organ, every aspect of you is clean and pure, starting from your tongue, your hands, your feet, your eyes. Everything should be pure and clean, because Islam teaches purity. As a person who is part of the faith of Islam, who believes that Islam is the most beautiful religion, wallahi, I tell you, it's amazing when you try to become a better person and learn to smile always, like you see I'm smiling, because there's no reason to be sad, whatever. Life is such that you cannot run away from tests. Small or big, they shall come, but with your trust and conviction in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would be able to sail through beautifully. But if tests were to take you farther away from Allah, then you still need to understand who Allah is and what life is all about. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ, Allah has said, we would surely test you. You know, Allah would surely test us. Allah tests those whom He loves. So my brothers, my sisters, let's spread love. Let's learn to fear Allah. Now social media has become such, and I always say, people are out there. It's like they've lost track. It's like we've become addicted to the social media platforms, addicted to our phones, and we now, shaitan has beautified so much sin for us, and he has normalized it for us that we engage in them and we don't even bat an eyelid. Remember, Allah is there, and it's Allah you shall be returning to. 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, no matter how long it might take, haram would always remain haram, irrespective of how it's been normalized in the society. It's your link with Allah that you're supposed to be walking on, my brothers, my sisters. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Barakallah feekum. Aqulu qawli hadha. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.